All right, people, we're back with more packs, back with the packs, and I got Tim here with me to do some packing. So I got 12 left in my booster box and four of the collector packs. So,
and I have a whole booster box.
I got a whole box of boosters
to open, along with more, but.
So that's the plan. That's what we're going to do, and we're going to do it now. All right, here we go. Strixhaven, School of Mages.
Very rarely do all the packs look exactly the same.
Oh, shit. Yeah, they are the same, aren't they?
All of them.
Yeah. All right, well, here goes Muffin. Cool-ass art card.
Indeed.
Some of these are worth money, but...
Huh. It's not signed, though.
No. We got a Plains. We got a Pest Summoning. 2/1/1 black and green pest with when they die, gain life. Okay. What are these random tokens doing here? Gotta get this shit out of our way. Alright. Green. Or, multicolored. Trample lifelink, 3-drop for 4. Alright. Professor of Zoomancy? Enter the battlefield, create a thing, a token, that when it dies, you gain a life. 4-drop, 4/3. Very good. Alright, we got a crocodile. Cram session, gain 4 life and learn.
Oh man, this was a good pack.
You got a show.
So far we got the Elder Dragon.
Oh shit.
The Boros Elder Dragon, that's a great, good first pull. Good first pull, it's a $5 card easily right now. Moving on. Good old memory lapse.
Oh, yeah.
Good old memory lapse. Decent instant. better than being put back in their hand.
Yeah, it gets put on the top of their library.
Yeah.
You just don't draw a card.
Yeah. It's not like Remand, though. It's not as good as Remand. Just kidding.
Wither Blooms.
Oh, and for the hollow.
All right.
The Return Past Caller. Cool name.
Very good. Got ourselves a land there. What does this guy do? Magecraft, whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery, you gain 1 life, 5-drop, 5/5. All right. I dig it.
That's good.
Mortality Spear, the spell costs 2 less if you cast, if you gain life this turn. Destroy target on land permanent. Okay, that's pretty cool. Oh, shit. Got a mythic. I'm going to cast an instant or sorcery spell from my graveyard. If the spell doesn't target a creature you control... If it doesn't target a creature I control.
I went to temple, so when I see a bird advisor that's an owl, I immediately get hostile. Temple University, temple owls. I don't know about that one.
This is interesting. Got Blue Sun Zenith.
I need them.
Oh, shit. Looks like we're going to have to make some trades, Morty.
I'm going to need one, Morty. I mean, Rick.
Campus Guide. So that's going to go there, and then we got the token. So I'm going to organize these up a little bit here. I'm going to move your shit over.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. So those are uncommons. These are my rares. We're going to put them over here. We'll just do something like this. What is this? Okay, it doesn't matter. All right.
I will trade you for that.
Okay.
Not as bad.
Only the Red Sun Zenith. All right. Next pack. Packing it up. Well, we definitely got a token. I hate when I do that. All right, so
pizza.
Full art card. Very good. We got ourselves a swamp. And then we have a random, uncommon.
Huh.
Exile target on land permanent. Its controller creates a token thing. Okay. Sure.
Another one.
2-drop, 5/4. You have to sacrifice a creature or pay 3.
Oh, I also got an uncommon first pull. I wonder if that's the way it is.
It's not always like that. It's random. I got a rare in the one pack, I'm pretty sure, that I opened up yours.
You did. It was upside down, too, I think.
Yeah, I'm just like, what is happening? All right. I've seen that guy. It's a bad fit into life. All right. As long as your turn has a lifelink, we've seen that. This guy's legendary, uncommon. Spirits get +1/+0. Whenever one or more cards leave your graveyard, create a 3/2 red and white spirit guy. Okay. You got this thing, 4-drop, 4/4. Whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, choose target creature card you control until end of turn. It gains this creature. If this creature would leave the battlefield, exile it instead of putting it anywhere else.
Yeah, he's like a must-take for Magecraft decks, honestly, if you're playing red-blue. Pretty Magecraft.
Cool. He's pretty good.
You want to run at least two of them.
He's a good one. Where did the rares go? Okay. A second rare, because I like double rares. When it enters the battlefield, look at the target opponent's hand, you may exile a non-land card from it. As long as that card remains exiled, the owner may play it. It costs two more to play. Okay. Whirlwind of Denial. That's pretty cool looking.
Pretty strong counter spell, actually.
Pretty cool.
If you can if you compare it to like a cancel.
I suppose, yeah.
I mean.
You may pay two rather than pay its mana cost. If it was paid, draw three cards, then the opponent creates two treasure tokens, and then scry two. If the cost wasn't paid, you draw X cards. Wait, what? Yeah, I got it, because it's an X card. Got it.
You draw three cards. Okay.
It's all right.
Huh. It's token. Foil,
though. It's foil. It is foil. Did you open yours yet?
Yeah, I got a little money card.
What'd you get? I got one of him, too.
Yeah.
It's good. I think we have three now between us.
Mm-hmm. He is actually pretty good. Remember when I cast an instant sorcery spell, you'd be paid, they may pay a tier that you don't make up the spell. Yeah. That's pretty amazing.
Get it on screen.
Yeah. So this card, yeah, the archaic dude.
He's archaic.
Yeah, he's a good man.
he's a good man.
Whenever an opponent casts an instant or sorcery spell, you know, it might be like 8 cards out of their 60 card deck. They pay 2, which they won't. You know, you can copy it.
It's pretty good. It's definitely a good sideboard card too.
Yeah. 5 colorless.
Yeah. What else did you get?
Oh, good old Agonizer Remorse. That's some cool art, man.
Yeah, I got a Japanese one.
That's even cooler.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
Nothing too fancy.
All right.
He's the woe eater, baby.
He's eating the woes.
He's foil, but he ain't no rare foil. You got that rare foil, that pack.
I did. All right, on to the next pack. All right.
What do we got?
I'll tell you what I got. I got a full art card, and a land.
A foil land.
A foil land. Look at me. Look at me go, Morty. All right. I've seen that before. Pop quiz. Draw a card and learn stuff. This is blue. We haven't gotten blue yet. Pigment Storm. We've seen that before. All right. Spectacle Mage. We've seen him before. Flying and Ward. Okay. I don't like you. Humiliate. I kind of like this card.
Whenever you can see their hand, that's always good.
Yeah, and you
people play. Underestimate how good that is. You choose an online card from it, especially if you're playing standard. If you're playing standard and you can see someone's hand, that's a huge advantage.
Yeah.
You choose an online card from it. Oh, the player discards that card. Oh, yeah.
And you get a plus one counter for, like, the other cost.
Yeah.
There's better cards, but I like that card.
If you're drafting, especially.
Yeah.
That's a good draft card.
Great. Sure.
Once again, like, Human Warlock, you're not working with a lot. You are working with human, that's good. In terms of keywords.
That is true.
But, like, yeah.
We've seen the Thunderous Orator as well. All right, what do we get? Gnarled Professor, 5/4, 4-drop with Trample. Whenever he enters the battlefield, you learn stuff.
That's good.
Cool. Village Rites.
Dude, I like that.
Those spells like Risk, draw 2 cards. All right, cool. And then we got this Quandrix Prodigy. It's a legendary creature. Pay 1 tap, and you put a land card from your hand on the battlefield tapped. Or pay 4 tap, draw a card. If you control 8 or more lands, draw 2 cards. All right. Sure. And we got an Inkling. All right.
Bringing it back, though. If we're talking about standard, though, the Demigoth Titan. This thing is a pretty mean card in Arena right now. Magic Arena.
Mm.
Whenever he attacks or blocks, you sack a creature, but he's a 4-drop for an 11-10.
Yeah. It's pretty good.
Yeah. So,
I wish he had trample or something, but it's fine.
You can give him trample. Not with black, though. But draw 2 cards, then proliferate for 3 and 2 life. That's the only way I would play that card. I'm telling you right now.
Oh, shit. You got something on the bottom there.
Yeah. Blood Jade, you know, a little spirit warrior. And artifact. That's it.
All right. All right. Next, we have a collector's booster. We're actually getting another one of these boxes from a good guy tomorrow.
A good man.
And he say, you get this box, and you get good things from this box for a good price of this box. Anyway, we're getting another box tomorrow.
Yep.
We're going to open this shit up.
It's going to be dope.
We're going to get
it's going to be actually
good things. We're going to get demonic foil. Dude. Or foil demonic tutors, you know? We're going to get 12
Japanese
of them.
Foil demonic tutors, dude. That's what we're
going to get. We're going to get 12.
We're going deep.
All right. Got to give it the love. Love packs.
Oh, that was a good pack, man.
A Pac-Man?
Yeah.
A David Pac-Man?
Yeah. Or Pac-Man from Smash.
All right, so a pest. A foil pest. I'm going to put these in their own pile like I have been doing because I want to know which cards are which. Oh!
Ooh.
Tower Oasis, though.
You got that backwards, y'all.
It always does that to me. All right, so we've seen this guy before, I'm pretty sure. Fine. Flying with Ward. I don't like you. Exhilarating Inoculation. 2++1 counters to target creature you control. Other creatures you control get +1/+1 until end of turn. All right. Yeah, I guess. I guess that's a card.
Oh, the big play.
Big play. +2/+2 gains reach, +1/+1 counter on it, so +3 basically with reach. Create a black 1/1 black and green pest guy with when it dies you gain life. It's a sorcery. And then you learn. I don't know. Sure. Divide by 0. You can't do that.
Oh yeah. You can
return target
0.
Spell or permanent with mana value 1 or greater to its owner's hand. So you can divide by 0?
Apparently.
I can't divide by 0.
Neither can I.
Fracture. Destroy target artifact, enchantment, or planeswalker. Cool.
Fracture's a good one.
You got the Introduction to Prophecy. Scry 2, then draw a card. It's a lesson.
Card.
It's a good one. Rob agrees.
Good card.
What is this guy? 2/1 for 2. Whenever an opponent activates an ability that isn't a mana ability, it deals 1 damage to them, and it can get +2/+0 until end of turn. Okay. Got the cool... I don't know what the symbol means, but... Got a bird cleric. Inklings can't attack you or planeswalkers you control whenever a player attacks... Whenever a player attacks one of your opponents, that attacking player creates a tap 2/1 white and black inkling creature token that isn't attacking. That's attacking. Interesting. I don't,
oh, man.
Don't know how I feel about that.
Super situational.
Strict.
Another rare.
The Strict Proctor. Oh, yeah, there's lots of rares in this thing.
Wow.
Whenever a permanent enters the battlefield, causes a... Whenever a permanent entry the battlefield causes an ability to get triggered. Oops. counter the ability unless it's controller pace 2. That's not bad. Opt. Scry 1, draw.
Good card.
Got one of these things.
Ooh, wow.
I forget what this is called. And then we got a Defiant Strike.
Look at that boy.
Oh, baby.
Ooh, we got the foil.
Okay.
I don't know.
That's
I
a
don't
demonic
know what that
tutor.
Is it?
That's like fucking $250 right there. Oh, baby.
This is what we do.
There it is, folks. I win.
This is what we do.
So that was crazy.
Oh, yes, it was. That was great. That was such a stroke of, honestly, great luck.
That was, yeah,
wow.
Unlucky.
You don't see it a lot, and it's great to see.
I'm so
No, happy. It really is. It's so satisfying to see. It
really is.
Yeah.
Took that one time I pulled the Force of Will.
Yeah,
exactly. Out of, like, a random pack out of the box. I was like, it's going to be in this pack. And they were like, nah, it's not. And I'm like, it is, though. And it was.
It's almost like you can will it to be, you know?
Like I will that it, force
it's,
of will
it's like
the
you
pack.
Make your own luck, yeah. And a weird sort of sounds like the way I've always seen it.
All right, here's another regular pack. Still got three more of these. What if I get a second one? Is that even possible? Probably not.
I think it is.
Art is good. Oop, and a forest. So art card. Forest card. Meh. Let's get these sleeves out of here. Get up on out of here with my eye holes. All right, so Fractal Summoning. We've seen this before. I think we've seen pretty much every card so far.
Yeah.
King's Lifelink. Yep, I've seen that one.
Close to, at least. Close to.
Okay. That's... Sure. Why not? We don't have a white stack, do we? I guess we can move these over. I didn't even realize we didn't have a white stack. So I moved all the cards that I had before, as you can tell, because when we started these videos, there were no cards on the table.
Yeah.
So next, I have another one of these, Exhilarating Inoculation. Guiding Voice. I've seen this before as well. Cool.
Yeah.
Promising Dusk Mage dies if it had a plus and plus encounter on draw a card. Sure, why not? What is this thing? A 2-drop 2/2. Whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, each opponent loses one life and you gain one life. That's alright for a 2-drop 2/2, right? It's not bad. I've been out of this game for so long, I don't know what's good anymore.
Good in draft. Yeah. Yeah, good in draft. Not good in constructed.
Oh my god, an 8-drop, 7/7 with trample. When I enter the battlefield, you gain 3 life and draw a card. I always like that. Mm-hmm. Put it from your graveyard on top of your library, third from the top.
I've actually had fun drafting this set on Magic Arena.
Yeah.
More so than Kaldheim, the set before. And also, like, it's a fun set to draft.
It seems like
it's different. It reminds me of when Invoke came out. And when
Invoke again? Oh, that's when, or is it Convoke or Invoke?
Well, Convoke and Invoke are different things. Okay. But also, my favorite, though, in the draft was Extort. That was a really fun mechanic.
I don't remember any of these things.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, you can, yeah. But, basically, you know, it's a fun Magecraft is a fun mechanic. It's working well.
Oh, well, I'll take your word for it. I haven't haven't drafted out of this yet.
That's Wait, what that one what? Box is for, though. But yeah, that's a good
We're
card.
Playing Quidditch, folks. And if you get enough Quidditch points, you win. And they lose. So you can add one, put a point counter on Strixhaven Stadium. Whenever a creature deals combat damage to you, remove a thing from the stadium. Whenever a creature you control deals combat damage to an opponent, that put a point on this thing. Then, if it has 10 or more, remove them all, and that player loses the game. Cool. Day of Judgment. Destroy all creatures.
Wow. Great pull again.
Good God.
Not a Wrath of God, but...
It's the same thing, basically. Yeah, obviously, they can be regenerated, but... Mm. You know.
Yeah, it's good.
It's cool.
It's great.
A heated debate. All right.
That's awesome.
What does this even do? Spell can't be countered. 4 damage to our creature planeswalker for 3. I don't hate it. And what?
Good old Cold Snap. Cold Snap.
Yeah, I got like some card from like it was so old. I don't know where it was from.
Shred deals damage to our creature equal to the number of Yeah, wow. Cool.
Huh.
Good card, actually.
I don't understand why this is in there.
Yeah, snow-covered mountains and, like, you know, all those lands. Like, that's a lot of permanents you can have. Yeah, it's not bad, like, for one red.
This is an old card in a new set.
Yeah, every pack, I think, comes with one.
Not every pack, but some. I've gotten other old cards, and I was like, this is weird.
I was thinking of the Time Spiral Remastered.
Okay.
You remember that?
Yeah.
With the purple, yeah.
Yeah, but these are, like, actual older cards.
Mm-hmm. Straight up.
Cool. Mm-hmm. I'll put this in the rare pile.
Cold Snap.
Maybe I'll just go to eBay and sell it for $400.
You should, like, make them bid on it. Yeah. Make them fight.
Minimum 200. All right, next pack. Pack number 2, and then we'll do another one, and then another collector one. Okay, so we got the Dragon Mage. We got Trogdor here.
There he is.
Trogdor was a man. a Plains? What does this do? Exile target non-land permanent. Its controller draws a card. It's a five drop lesson. I don't like you. I dislike you.
Yeah.
Curate. Look at the top two cards of your library. Put any number of them into your graveyard and the rest back on top of your library in any order. Draw a card. So a way worse ponder. Got it. Okay. Biblioplex Assistant. Flying. When Biblioplex Assistant enters the battlefield, put up to one target instant or sorcery card from your graveyard on top of your library. Four drop, 2/1. I'll rip that in half, I'm sure. Flying Death Touch, 1/1. Okay, fine, for two. It's not the worst card I've ever seen.
No.
Okay, so double this dude's power and toughness until end of turn. Interesting, so you can do it multiple times. Okay. If you really wanted to. Befuddle the Frog Man. The Frog Wizard Man. Flash, when it comes into the battlefield, -1/-0.
He's a frog wizard.
He's a frog man. Just like Trogdor. Except he's a frog. Test of Talents. Counter target instant or sorcery spell for two. Search its controller's graveyard, hand, and library for any number of the cards of the same name as that spell in exile. Okay, so it's basically a... That's interesting.
It's not bad.
No, it's not bad at all.
Mm-hmm.
How much does negate cost?
Two. For pretty much the same thing, you know.
Negate?
It's just, you can yeah. With negate, you can target enchantments and artifacts.
Negates anything, right?
Anything but a creature.
Non-creature.
Anything but a creature, yep. So that's pretty good.
That's interesting. Yeah, this is good. Especially against Tim's blue-red burn deck, which has no creatures in it. -X, -X, where X is 7. We've seen this before. All right, we got another Trogdor here. Flying and Trample. When he enters the battlefield, double the number of +1/+1 counters on target creature you control. Whenever he attacks, you may have the base power and toughness of other creatures you control become equal to this guy until end of turn. Okay, I mean, Flying Trample, 4/4 for 5. That seems okay. I'm not sure what this is. Oh, Natural Order. As an additional cost to cast a spell, sacrifice a green creature. Search the library for a green creature card, put it on the battlefield, and shuffle. Wow. That's really good. You can do some really dumb combos with that.
The Elder Gorgoroth, dude.
All right. Inoculation. Trogdor was a man. There it goes.
Yes.
All right. We're going to keep it rolling. What'd you get?
Here's what we got. The Malstorm Muse. Pretty sweet card.
The Muse?
It's alright. I'm just kidding. It's good to drift. Good to drift. The Poet's Quill. Enters battlefield, learn. Cost okay. 2. Alright.
It's not terrible. Seen better, but...
The Whirlwind Denial, which we've already seen tonight.
Yep.
And nothing good. The Quidditch Campus.
The Quidditch Campus. All right. We're going back to the Quidditch. All right. Packing it up. Packing it in. Let me begin. I'm not going to sing a song. All right. So we got another thing. This is pretty crazy looking. That's really cool. I really like these full art cards that they're giving you. That's pretty cool. Foil land. Pest summoning. We've seen that. Not bad for a 3-drop thingamabob. Those. We've seen this as well. Not bad. Create 2 blue elemental creature tokens. You can discard it and you get a treasure token. You discard it by paying 2. Getting all my junk in the way. Junk out of my trunk.
Oh, man.
Okay, so exile target artifact or creature. Its controller gets the thing. Okay. Whenever you cast an instant or sorcery spell, copy it. You may choose new targets for the copy. 2-drop. Okay.
Yeah, 2-drop.
How much does fork? How much does fork cost? 1, right? It's 1 red.
Fork?
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
Old ass card.
Ah.
Anyway. Dueling coach enters the battlefield, +1/+1 counter target creature. 5, tap it, put a plus one counter on each creature you control with a plus one counter on it. You're a 4 drop 2-2. You seem bad. Mm-hmm. Oop, wrong pile. Magecraft, whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, put a plus one counter on this guy. No thanks. Culmination of Studies. Interesting. Exile the top X cards of your library. For each land card exiled this way, create a treasure token. For each blue card exiled this way, draw a card. For each red card exiled this way, it does 1 damage to each opponent. I can see that being pretty damn good. If you have a bunch of multicolored cards, you get both effects. All right. So, we now have Kian, Dean of Substances. She a drug addict. Exile the top card of your library. If it's a land card, put it into your hand. Otherwise, put a study counter on it. Okay. Create a fractal creature token. Put a plus one counter on it for each different mana value among non-land cards you own in exile with study counters on them. Sure. And then on the other side, we have this. X and 2, tap, exile top X cards of your library, and put a study counter on each of them. Then you may put a card you own in exile with a study counter on it into your hand. Okay.
Doesn't flip over, does it?
It does.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so we already went over that one. Interesting. Not sure how I feel about that. Adventurous Impulse. Look at the top 3 cards of your library. You may reveal a creature card or creature or land card from among them and put it into your hand. Put the rest on the bottom of your library in any order. Alright. Expressive Iteration. Look at the top 3 cards of your library. Put one of them into your hand. Put one on the bottom of your library. And one of them is exiled. You may play the exiled card. That seems okay. And then we got that thing.
Yeah. Here we got the Venerable Warsinger. Great card right now. It's a 3-3 for 3, Vigilance Trample.
Got one him too at some point.
Yeah, he's fantastic right now.
He's awesome.
Very, very Boros-y. And he's needed in a good like Boros deck right now. We got Village Rites.
Good stuff.
And a Hollow Poet's Quill. If you're playing Learn, you can use this in black, but that's about it.
Cool stuff. Coolio stuff. All right. It's time for a collector booster. All right. Here it is. Second Demonic Tutor. Here we go. Yeah, wouldn't that be insane?
I'm going to say you're drawing a Damnation.
There's a Damnation you can get?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
I know.
Another foil treasure token. Okay. Oh. No, this is different. We're going to put these in a different pile. Whenever you gain life, you may play one. If you do, put a plus one counter on each creature you control, and those creatures gain trample until end of turn. Wow. That's pretty cool. So I got 2 foil cards in this pack. It's going to be a good pack, folks. I have a good feeling. Oh, it actually flips. Sorry.
Oh.
A 1-drop, 1-1 with Menace and Lifelink. If a non-token creature an opponent controls would die, exile it instead. When you do, you may pay 2. If you do, create a 1-1 black and green pest guy. Huh. Okay.
Yeah, pretty damn good.
Yeah. Pretty darn good, I'd say.
Foil.
Foils are fun. Gotta get those silicone packs and make your foils not bend. Have we seen this guy before? Yeah, we've seen him before. Sure.
Yeah.
Sure, why not?
Yeah.
Okay, when Pilgrim the Agent of the Battlefield, reserve a basic planes card. Reveal, put it into your hand and shuffle. Yep, we've seen him as well. I've seen this guy many times as well. Mm. I think we saw it in the previously. Dueling Coach, we've seen you. All right, we've seen this one. I think I got the same one in the last pack.
The Prodigy.
Okay, so that's... There's a common.
Yes.
Mr. Ghost Forge. Spirit creatures you control, spirits you control, +1/+1, trample haste. Whenever a non-token creature you control dies, exile it. If you do, create a token that's a copy, except it's a spirit in addition to its other types, and has when this creature leaves the battlefield, return the exiled card from your graveyard. Return the exiled card to your graveyard. Excuse me. Ooh, what are you? Whenever a player attacks one or more opponents, one of your opponents, I can't read, obviously. I have dyslexia. It's hard.
Bird Warlock.
If that opponent has more life than another of your opponents, the attacking player draws a card, and you may put +2/+1 counters on creatures you can on a creature you control. Huh.
Pretty good.
The Demagogue. Legendary Bird Demagogue.
Ooh,
copy target creature spell that you control, except it isn't legendary if it is. That seems good.
It is good. That's very cool.
Doesn't clone like do the same thing?
Yeah, for more mana.
does clone any permanent?
I don't think so.
Wow.
I don't think with clone you can do legendary creatures though.
Well, if you did, it would just die.
Yeah.
Cultivate. I'm tired of seeing this goddamn card.
Right.
Ooh. Not sure what that is, but it's Japanese. Not sure what that is, but it's foil wow. Japanese.
All right.
Cool. Very good.
Yes.
Go.
Little mascot exhibition. It's actually pretty good.
You get create the little, so you get each token type?
You get like a white and black inkling. You get, you know, all the schools.
Do I have a card that says learn handy? It puts it into your hand, right? When you learn?
It's kind of like...
not onto the battlefield?
I don't exactly know, to be honest.
Okay. I'll have to double check that.
Yeah. I'm not sure, 100%. Throwing Discovery is a good card. But those are all commons we've seen before. Boom.
I kind of like that guy. So he learns, right? You may really lesson card you own from outside the game and put it into your hand. Yeah, so... I actually prefer to discard and draw a card with learn.
Yeah.
I'm sure that there's some... Ooh. I'm sure that there's some good things you can do with that, you know, with learning and getting a card, but... Brainstorm.
We'll take the brainstorm, man. What a great draw. I'll take that.
That is great.
Yeah. I mean, if it was hollow, that'd be even better, but...
It's like ponder, isn't it? Isn't that exactly what ponder does?
Brainstorm? No.
Look at the top 3 cards of your library... Put them back in any order, draw a card.
No, ponder lets you like scry more so. Like brainstorm, you just draw 3
and put 2 back.
Yeah.
In any order though.
Yes.
It's like the same thing. In effect.
It's a reverse order kind of.
I feel like that's the same thing.
Like you look at the top 3 and then you draw one of them. You know, that's ponder, right? And then the brainstorm is you just draw.
Put them back
the
in
top
any order,
3.
Draw.
And then the brainstorm is just you draw 3. And then you put 2 back in anywhere. It's like the race. It's the same thing, but it's just
that's
reversed. Yeah, exactly. It's funny as shit. Oh, I can't. I will use that card, probably.
That is a good card. All right, next pack here for Tim.
We're going deep. Little Inklings. Bird Boys. Yeah. Exile Tart Effect. Alright, so this one's actually not that bad. Exiled target artifact or creature. Its controller puts a 4/4 blue and red elemental creature token.
I guess it depends what you're exiling, but...
Yeah.
Could be good.
Mm-hmm. It's a last minute card. Maybe. In a draft or something. Not for me. Reconstruct history. Cool theme.
Can't rewrite history.
Yeah,
okay, that's not bad.
Not bad at all.
Ooh, what's that?
The rare land is always good. Tap for a colorless, pay a colorless, add 1 E.
Okay,
know,
so it's
one.
A filter land, which is cool.
Mm-hmm. Put a +1 counter on target. On target creature, okay. Actually,
if you cast an instant or sorcery spell this turn. Okay.
Not could
too
be
shabby.
Could be really good, actually. I think. Could be really
good. It's another rare.
Yeah, the Flame Scroll Celebrant. Whenever an opponent activates an ability, which is
cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Does it flip?
It do. Oh, shit. Yeah. I didn't even know that on the other one that I had.
Revel in Silence.
Your opponent can't cast spells or activate Planeswalker loyalty abilities this turn. Exile it.
I like it a lot.
That's really good.
Yeah. Reminds me of, there was an old spell from way back in the day. I don't remember what it's called now. I think it was Render Silent was what. It was a counter spell, and then they couldn't activate.
Orm's Chant is better.
Yeah,
that's old, mm-hmm. old, but
yeah, that's yeah. super old. Yeah. But yeah, but there's also like, another. There's a card in between there too. I remember.
Yeah, I remember Render. Render Silent's a counter spell, right?
Yeah, Render Silent's a counter spell.
Yeah, there was a one white instant
exactly
prevented yeah. your opponent from what like, is casting
it?
Spells.
Exactly. I'm trying to think of what it was called because called. That's what I'm thinking of. Yeah. It reminded me of Periphery Nodes, but it's not Periphery Nodes. It's something else.
I don't remember.
Yeah,
I don't remember.
It's like Silence or something.
It might just be called Silence.
It might be called Silence.
Nah. Nah.
No.
Render Silence really good.
Yeah.
So count of that, you're fucked. Yeah. My turn.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Orm's Chant was so good. They couldn't cast spells or attack a creature. And then you would put it on an Ishran Scepter and you do it every turn.
That's it for this turn. Yeah.
Alright. Alright, here we go. Three packs and then a collector pack. Open. Sesame. And says me. All right. So there is our art card. That's really cool looking. A mountain. We've seen this. This battlefield tapped. Sacrifice lands you pay one. Add one mana of any color. Sure. Search the library for a basic forest card, put that card onto the battlefield tapped, then shuffle and learn. Okay, I like learning. When you can discard and then draw. It seems good.
Oh yeah.
Draw a card, then discard a card.
Okay.
Magecraft. Whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, put a +1/+1 counter on him. We've seen him before. I kind of like that. That's pretty good. Ooh, what's this?
The saddle.
It's the satchel.
It looks like a saddle. Okay. I'm looking at it through
the phone, but yeah. Whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, put a book counter on the satchel. Remove one book counter, add colorless mana, remove three, draw a card. All right. I can see that coming in handy. Mm-hmm. Storm Kill an Artist. +1/+0 for each artifact you control. Whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, create a treasure token. Okay. Little dwarf guy. Oh, yeah, he is a dwarf. Dwarf shaman.
Little dwarf boy.
I thought dwarves didn't dabble in the magic.
They usually don't. This one's special.
Whenever, when sparring regiment enters the battlefield, learn. Whenever you attack, put a +1/+1 counter on target attacking creature and untap it. Okay, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
I have a lot. Selfless Glyph Weaver. Exile a selfless Glyph Weaver. Creatures you control gain indestructible until end of turn.
Does it flip? No.
It does flip.
Oh, baby.
You got a sorcery. Choose a creature or planeswalker, then destroy all other creatures and planeswalkers.
Jesus.
Okay. Eliminate. Ooh. We've seen that before.
Card.
It's very good. Uncommon. Whenever you cast an instant or sorcery spell, until end of turn, spirit creatures you control gain tap. Deal with damage. Okay. Cool. And we got the Fractal. Look at this cool thing.
It's a pretty sweet creature.
It is pretty cool
for
looking.
For being a token.
Pretty cool stuff.
He's a big boy.
What'd you get? Anything good?
Let's see. So we got a little Light Scribe. He's okay. A little Duress.
Okay. Duress is good.
And a thrilling discovery.
Mm. Very good. Very thrilling. All right. On to the next one. We got the cool art card there. Got a forest. We've seen environmental sciences. We've seen the campus.
going to bother me. I'm very particular. Oh, wrong pile. Wrong pile again. Wrong pile again. Right, now I'm dumb. I'm a stupid man. There we go. I keep thinking the foils are rares because they usually... Yeah, anyway.
Yeah.
All right, so we've seen this guy. When he enters the battlefield, tap target creature an opponent controls. That creature doesn't untap until its next untap step. Okay. Charge through, seen that. Trample, draw a card for one. I love it.
Not bad at all.
Two less to cast if you've cast another instant or sorcery spell this turn. So it's one green if you've cast something. Target creature you control gets +1/+2 until end of turn. Then fight to target creature you don't control. Interesting. It's a sorcery. So I guess you could use it in your end step after you've attacked.
You could.
Seems good. Seems okay. Dragon's Approach. This is funny. Dragon's Approach deals 3 damage to each opponent. You may exile Dragon's Approach and 4 cards named Dragon's Approach from your graveyard. If you do, search your library for a dragon creature card, put it onto the battlefield, then shuffle. A deck can have any number of cards named Dragon's Approach.
Oh, wow.
It's just funny. Alright. Team Pennant, +1/+1, Vigilance, Trample. Equip a token for 1, equip a regular guy for 3. We got a Necro Blossom Snarl. Reveal a swamp or forest card from your hand. If you don't, it comes into play tapped, black or green.
That's a good card.
Yeah. Claim the Firstborn. So I got a Japanese one of these. Gain control of target creature with magic value 3 or less until end of turn. Untap that creature, gains haste. Cool. Witherbloom Pledge Mage. Whenever you cast an instant or sorcery spell, you gain 1 life. And then a pest. Very pesty. Look at that thing. That's ugly as shit.
Yeah, it is. It's like one of the ball and chains from Mario. It's purple. For some reason. Well, here's what we got. The 2 rares.
Weather the Storm's cool.
Yeah, Weather the Storm is cool. And we got the Callous Blood Mage. Not very good.
Yeah, not a huge fan.
Yeah. But we also got the Gatekeeper. Gatekeeper of Malakir. Okay. Great card. Wow.
Oh, that's an old card.
Enters the battlefield. Yep. If it was kicked, target a player sacrifices a creature.
All right.
So it's removal.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
For 3 black. 2/2.
I like it. Getting towards the end. Got 1 more of these. Collector booster after that. 3 more regulars. And then the last collector booster. Where I fully plan on getting a second demonic tutor. Which is impossible. But
no, it's so possible.
All right. We've seen this. We've seen you. We've seen you. I'm pretty sure this is the same pack that I just opened. At the beginning of your end step, mill a card. I think we saw this as well. Lorehold Excavation. At the beginning of your end step, mill a card. If it was a land card, you gain 1 life. Otherwise, it deals 1 damage to each opponent. Exile a creature card from your graveyard. Create a tapped 3/2 red and white spirit creature token. Okay. Spirit you control get +1/+0. Whenever 1 or more cards leave your graveyard, create a 3/2 red and white spirit creature token. Meh. I got 3 Boros cards in a row. Return up to 1 target artifact card, up to 1 target enchantment card, and up to 1 target instant card from your... Wait, what? Artifact, enchantment, instant, sorcery, planeswalker from your graveyard to your hand. Okay, yeah. That's the one Tim got. That's the 4th in a row.
Nice.
Well, 4th Boros card.
Yep.
Okay, we've seen you. And I got that same land you got. Hall of Oracles. That's really cool art. Look at that. It's really cool. Memory Lapse. Counter target spell. If it was countered, put it on top of the owner's library. We just saw that earlier. I'll put that there. And no one cares about that. Yeah. Did you get anything good in yours?
Yeah. So, we got the Demonic Finale, which is a cool black-white card. It gives creature tokens +1/+1. And basically, if you have any creatures that are not tokens, they become tokens with +2/+1. Or they become a 2/1, black and white Inkling token.
When they die.
When they die.
Okay, cool.
That's good.
And then we have a... Oh, he looks cool.
Yeah. He's a big boy.
Auric Overlord, double strike, 2/4 for 4. Whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery, return target non-legendary creature cards from your graveyard to your hand. Cool. Oh, he flips.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I never even knew that because I got one and didn't even know it flipped. Because I don't play games well.
Awaken the Blood Avatar for 8.
This will cost to cast a spell. You may sacrifice any number of creatures. This spell costs 2 less to cast for each creature sacrificed. Each opponent sacrifices a creature. Create a 3/6 black and red avatar creature token with haste. Whenever this creature attacks, it deals 3 damage to each opponent. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
She's hilarious, by the way.
Very good.
Very good.
She's one of my favorite.
Let's go to it.
So, we have the Pest Creature Token. Wrong pile. Okay. Whenever you cast an cast or copy an instant or sorcery, whatever, we saw you already. All right. Eureka Moment, we've seen this. Draw 2 cards. You may put a land card from your hand onto the battlefield. Sure. Create some fractals. Okay, I don't think so. We've seen this before. Field Trip. Search the library for a basic forest card, put it on the battlefield tapped, then shuffle and learn things. Art and Dustbreaker, I feel like I've seen this. Whenever he attacks, you may put an instant or sorcery card from your graveyard on the bottom of your library. If you do, exile the top two cards of your library. You may play those cards this turn. Okay. That's actually pretty good.
Yeah, it is.
Cool. Very, very good for this color because they gain they gain life. Yeah, I really like that. It's really easy to combo.
Yep.
Inkling Summoning. Create a single creature token for 3. Seems bad.
Yeah.
Alright, so then we got this guy. Whenever he deals combat damage to a player, you may return target creature card with mana value X or less from your graveyard to the battlefield, where X is the amount of damage that he dealt to that player. Like, Vigilance and Trample. Imagine him with, like, some sort of equipment or with, like, some pluses on him or something.
Some hexproof.
Or, you know, getting him out early somehow or something. Like, you can just do stuff. I feel like he's better in Modern than he is in...
Yeah.
Standard.
He is. He is much better Modern than he is in Standard.
For each permanent type, return up to 1 card of that type from your graveyard to the battlefield. You lose 3 life for each card returned this way. Exile.
Old card. Kind
of. It's a 6 drop?
Yeah.
Cool. That's awesome looking art. Because I just got this land. No, this is a different one, I think. Did I get this one already?
You got another Snarl.
I got another Snarl? Okay. Well, I got a new Snarl here. Island or Forest enters the battlefield tapped otherwise. Or so you reveal it, enters the battlefield tapped otherwise. I feel like these are also better in Modern because of Ravnica Dual Lands, because they count. It doesn't say basic. It's just Forest or Island card. So that's cool. Infuriate.
I like that card, actually.
+3,
+2. I
want to
make it work, but I haven't found a way yet.
I've gotten another one of these. I don't remember what it is.
Is it Negate?
It's not Negate. Maybe it's Negate. I don't remember.
Maybe it's Lapse the Memory or whatever.
Shock. Foil Shock. Increasing Vengeance. Copy target instant or sorcery spell you control. The spell. If the spell is cast from your from a graveyard, copy that spell twice instead. What? So if you play something with Flashback.
Yeah.
And you use this, you copy it twice. It says that the spell was cast from your graveyard, so if you do a flashback card, you're casting it from your graveyard.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. That's pretty cool. Better in modern.
Yep.
Good shit, folks. All right, here we go. Three more, and then the last booster from the collector box, and we're done until I get the next collector box, which is going to be tomorrow.
Indeed.
Card.
It's going to be fun.
I want to go there. Looks like a beautiful place to spend my life.
Yeah. Post-Terran society, dude.
Comes your choice of a blue frog with okay, I like snake form better, even though it's three. I think it's three, right? Whenever a creature blocks his turn, its controller loses one life. All right, interesting. I don't think I've seen this one. Extus, Rise of Extus. Exile target creature, exile to one target, instant or sorcery card from a graveyard, and learn for six. No thanks. Plus two, minus two. Okay. Each player loses two life. You draw two cards for four. No thanks. Reflective Golem. Whenever you cast an instant or sorcery spell that only targets Reflective Golem, you pay two less. If you do, copy that spell. You may choose new targets for the copy. That seems good. Legendary creature, Orc Shaman. That's an orc. Okay. Pay two, return this person to its owner's hand. Copy target instant or sorcery spell you control. You may choose new targets for the copies. Okay, it's interesting. It's a creature, so that you can kind of get effed over with that. But, Human Cleric. As it enters the battlefield, choose a non-land card name. Whenever an opponent casts a spell with the chosen name, they lose 3 life and you draw a card. Interesting. I guess that's a card you can play.
It is now. And that's the boy that flips, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I forgot he flipped. Totally flips, yeah. Opponents can't cast spells or activate Planeswalker loyalty abilities this turn. Exile it. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
All right. Harmonize. Hey!
That's cool.
It's the first one I've gotten.
Good to have.
Yeah. Man. I mean, I have a playset, old ones. But that's the first new one I've gotten. Beaming Defiance, we've seen you before. And the creature token. White. Very few white cards. Elemental 4/4 boy.
Luckily, I drew Belladross, man.
What does he do?
He's an Elder Dragon.
Oh, he's the black-green Elder Dragon. So
during each upkeep, he makes a 1/1 pest. With, like, when he dies, he gets a life. And then,
pay 10 life on the tap of a land you control?
Yep.
Wow. Okay. Yeah.
So he's interesting.
Yeah.
And then we got a little Despark.
What does that do? Exile target permanent with mana 4 or greater. Okay.
White and black.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
I'll take it.
All right. Here we go again. Hopefully we're going through these a little bit faster now because you've seen a lot of the cards. Birdman. Bird person. Scry two, then draw a card. Okay, is this a lesson? It is a lesson. I've seen this before. It's okay. Land. Campus Guide, and there's a battlefield, search your library for a basic land card, reveal it, then shuffle and put the card on top. I guess there are worse cards than that. It's an artifact creature, so it's, well, you could put it in an artifact deck. Basic land card? Yeah, okay. Sure. Explosive Welcome. 5 damage to any target and 3 damage to any other target. Add 3. Okay. Whenever you cast this spell, copy it. If you control Planeswalker, Cleric, Druid, Shaman, Warlock, or Wizard, scry one, then draw a card. Okay, I can see that being comboed pretty crazily. Put a 3. Counter target instant or sorcery spell. Searches, controls, graveyard, hand. Oh, we saw this already. Yeah, so this is like an extra pate for your counter spell. that targets an instant sorcery. Another Snarl. That's some really cool art.
Oh, that's a good Snarl. You know, it's funny. I also have this.
Yeah. Snarl. Do you want to trade for my Snarl for your
Snarl?
Your blue red burn deck?
I'm thinking about it. I'm thinking it's worth it.
I have four.
Yes, I do. Want
to whatever they called. Boiler rooms or whatever. The old school Dimir.
Yeah.
Or not Dimir.
The Boiler Works?
Yes. The Boiler Works.
Is it Boiler Works?
The Boiler Works. It's rare. It's
Snarl. Got Infuriate.
Duress. Good card.
Yeah. Duress is good.
Don't care. This is old. Is there anything underneath this? No. Haunt. When this creature dies, exile haunting. Okay. When this creature dies, exile a haunting target creature. When it enters the battlefield or the creature it haunts dies, create 2/1/1 black bat creature tokens with flying. This is old. I forget what set this is from.
I do too.
But, alright. We'll put that in the rares just because. Alright. Two more. I'm gonna do something special. I'm gonna open it from this side.
Ooh.
We've seen that. We've seen that. We've seen that. Yep, we've seen that. Dragon's Approach, we've seen that because it's hilarious. Heated Debate. We've seen that. Ooh, what do you do? When returned Palcaller enters the battlefield, return target spirit instant sorcery card from your hand. Okay. Sure. Professor of Symbology. Isn't that something from Harry Potter?
Probably. No, not. Yeah.
We got the Quill. Same one that Tim got. And as battlefield learn, a quick creature has +1/+1 in lifelink. If only it had trample. And +2/+2. An opt. Scry one, draw a card. Trample, lifelink, 3/3 for 4. I don't hate it. And then a pest creature token. Alright.
Well, we got a double major, as we saw earlier. But not as cool. Not foil. We'll take it, though. And then we got a cool old card, the Magic 25th Anniversary set.
Destroy target artifact or land. It can't be regenerated for 3. Pillage?
Yeah.
Yeah. Very good.
Cool card.
Next.
I don't think it is.
It does.
Yep. That's what it is.
The Electrolyze. I'd like the Electrolyze. Even though it's not a money card or anything, but I would like it.
Mm-hmm.
Here's the Inkling. Boy, oh. Alright. Pledge Mage. Variant Books, 2 less to cast. If it targets an attacking creature, put target creature on its owner's library, second from the top. Okay. Tap up to 2 target creatures and then learn stuff. Spell costs 2 less to cast. If you've cast another instant or sorcery, yep, we've seen that before. Okay. Reach whenever a creature you control with power equal to its toughness attacks, it gains trample until end of turn. Doesn't seem bad. So it's basically got reach and trample for 4/4/4.
Right.
You've seen this guy? I like him. Mercurial Transformation. Until end of turn, target non-land permanent loses all abilities. So we just saw this a few minutes ago. Exponential Growth. Until end of turn, double target creature's power X times. Okay. And we got the cool new art or new symbol. I don't know what that symbol means.
I don't know either.
So it's like a Dark Confidant for you and your opponent? Reveal top card of your library. You each lose a life equal to the mana value. Oh, I think Dark Confidant just made you lose one life every time. It's been a long time since I've seen it and read what it does. Mm. That looks cool.
That one.
Troll Druid Trample 3/3 for 3. As long as you control 8 or more lands, it gets +5/+5.
Flip it.
Target creature you control. Choose target creature you control. Each other creature you control becomes a copy until the end of turn, except those creatures aren't legendary, if it was legendary. Sweet.
Yeah, that's a really good card.
Seems good.
That's really good right now. The other side of it's really good.
So we got another one of these. I don't know what this is. It's not Dark Ritual.
No.
Growth Spiral. Okay. I don't know what this is. But it's another foil Japanese card. Multiple choice. Okay, so you get to... If you basically pay 4 for this, for the X, you scry 1, draw a card. A player returns a creature they control to its hand, and you create a blue and red elemental creature token. Cool.
Yeah.
And that's it. That's all we got. That's all she wrote. This was the best thing.
Oh my gosh.
This thing was awesome. Look at it. The art is just so cool. Look at his face.
Pay for the whole box.
Yeah, seriously. Yep. It's fine. We're just going to pull another one in the box we open tomorrow. Until then...